Breaking news, Nigerians. Fuel subsidy wahala. Nigerians, they don't cast. Fayose says send strong message to Tinubu and made fuel crisis. See what he said that shocked everyone. Welcome back to Prospect Channel TV. Thank you for always coming out here. If you are just joining us, please kindly subscribe and don't forget to give us a thumbs up. The former governor of Ekiti State, Ayodele Fayose, has advised that President Bola Ahmed Tinubu stick with his decision to end fuel subsidies. This accusation was made on May 30 by Ayodele Fayose, the former governor of Ekiti State. He ascertained that President Tinubu must be firm and resolute with oil holders and marketers. President Bola Ahmed Tinubu has been encouraged by the former governor of Ekiti State, Ayodele Fayose, to deal with those who are abusing the withdrawal of subsidies. The pragmatist Fayose announced this on May 31st in a message posted to his official Twitter account. His tweet reads, "Sadly, like tropical Nigerians who are always desirous of taking advantage of every situation, the fuel marketers are only interested in making money for themselves," he added. "And I think the government should come very hard on them this time. Anyone among them found to be hoarding fuel or selling at exorbitant rates, should be dealt with." President Tinubu, according to Fayose, is not a magician, but he can plan with his team to reposition the nation to adhere to the best principles of economic development. He urged the various pressure groups and other stakeholders to give President Tinubu's administration the benefit of the doubt, claiming that the past administrations had failed to carry out this decision, removing the fuel subsidy. Fayose said, "Many governments have come and paid lip service to all these issues. It is time to sustain our country by taking decisions that may be seen as harsh, but can return the country back to the path of progress." The NLC and all interested parties, especially ordinary Nigerians, should realize that the last administration did more danger and the new government can only be finding ways and means to stabilize the country, he added. However, he advised Nigerians to be patient, saying the current hardship would pass quickly. President Tinubu's choice, according to Fayose, was the greatest and the smartest way for the general welfare of Nigeria and its citizens. He said, "I apologize to Nigerians to bear with the government for now, as the present hardship will ease out with time. Removing the fuel subsidy is the best thing to do, and it has to be done once and for all." Similar to this, a Nigerian organization has approved Bola Tinubu's plan to gradually eliminate the country's gas line subsidies. Mohammed Afa, the organization's national coordinator, claimed that eliminating subsidies would benefit Nigeria in a number of ways. He claimed that by getting rid of it, Nigeria will have more money to invest in other crucial areas of the economy. Okay, this is good though, like I always say. Now, these people can never be trusted. How are we now sure that if this fuel subsidy is removed, the money will be utilized the way they are saying it? Because while Nigerians are afraid, they have betrayed us time without number. They don't make promises like this and they don't fulfill them. You understand? So that is why Nigerians are like, we don't trust these people. Because if you come today and tell us this and tomorrow something else will happen. Okay, let's take example of what happened when President Muhammadu Buhari, you know, blocked borders. What happened? He told us that with that, you know, closing the borders, Nigerians will be, you know, producing rice. They will go into farming. They will be producing rice here. And the rice will be far, far better, cheaper than what we have been buying before. because closing the border, no foreign rice will come in. Then we now have to deal with our rice, our produce here, and it will be cheaper. But it was like the worst policy he had ever made. And that was the beginning of a food crisis in Nigeria. You know why you are making such a policy? We are going to somewhere. We have bandits in the forest. Fulani herdsmen, they are all in people's farms, chasing people. They will take their crops to people's farms to eat up their crops. Then when you challenge them, they will take off your head from your body. Bandits chase farmers from their ancestral homes. People can no longer go to their farms to farm because of being fear, you know, because of fear of being kidnapped or killed. Now, the government did not take care of that first before closing the border. Nigerians are no longer going to the farm. And boom, no rice in the country because the rice farmers are no longer in the farms. Bandits, Boko Haram, Fulani herdsmen have chased them from their farm. Okay, tell me, how are we now going to get the rice cheap? Now, that one is one. Fuel subsidy problem. I'm calling this problem because it's a very big problem to Nigeria. The matter not be today starts. It's a very big problem. Now, you are removing fuel subsidy now. We don't have any working refinery in Nigeria. You have not even put in all those ones in places. I be the Dangote own. Nine be the thing. Now, what about civil servants? How do you think Nigerians, common Nigerians, will survive with this, even with the harsh situation we are facing now? Things are difficult. We just try to, you know, try to cope with this one. Now you want to hit us, boom. Not be like that. Nobody's saying that the fuel subsidy should stay, because there are some people who are using this, you know, to build their 10 generations to come. But you have to put things in place first, so that even when we are bringing out 1,000 to buy a liter, we will not feel it. But this one now, Nigerians, there is fire on the mountain. It go hit everybody, not be safe. Now, I am asking this question again. What is the guarantee that after removing this fuel subsidy, because he said he's going to use it in infrastructure, health sector, and all that, unemployment, whatever, and all that, and palliatives for vulnerable Nigerians. I don't know as they tell they know vulnerable Nigerians. How are we not sure that this money that we realize from this fuel subsidy will be useful? They will use it for the benefit of the country. You see, the reason why Nigerians do not trust our leaders anymore. I'm dropping it here, guys. Kindly share your thoughts below the comment section. Please, do not forget to subscribe to